this morning. Brian Eby will kick off for Central Michigan. Chris Lacy and Jeff Carr are back deep for Oklahoma State. The late arriving crowd on this early Saturday morning, and we're underway. It'll be Carr letting it go through the end zone, and Oklahoma State will start at the 25. What to watch for when Oklahoma State has the ball.
James Washington is the best wide receiver in the Big 12, a big playmaker. They did not go down the field much to him in their first game. I expect to see more of that in this one, and he can go up and get it. Only about 6 feet tall, but he plays a lot taller. Joe Ostman has got to come from the edge and get heat on Mason Rudolph, where it's going to be a long afternoon for the Chips. They have to find a pass rush up front.
Chris Carson, the starting tailback here on first down. Rudolph will pass, and he throws and completes the pass to James Washington. Washington, one of those key players, tackled by Josh Cox, picks up seven. Rudolph, 29 career touchdown passes. You mentioned he threw for over 3,700 yards last year.
And you saw how comfortable he was there. Just a real easy out route to Washington. Get things started, get the ball in the hands of your playmakers.
Touch pass here, shovel pass to McCluskey, Jalen McCluskey. And he'll pick up the first down. Gets 5 yards. Briones and Cox combine for the tackle. Oklahoma State goes quickly. Hand off to Carson, trying to turn the corner. And Carson gets tackled by Briones and Cox. Once again, Josh Cox has been busy in on all three stops.
Yeah, and that's a two straight for Alex Briones as well. He's doing a good job playing that inside out, getting to the sideline. A nice stop on the second down play, and then getting to Carson before he can turn his shoulders, big shoulders, up the field and do some damage.
Now Justice Hill takes over in the backfield. Quick pass, high throw, caught by McCluskey, and he was hit right away, wrapped up by Winslow Chapman, a pickup of two. So third down and eight coming up here for Oklahoma State.
And this is a lot of what we talked about with Mike Yurcich, the offensive coordinator for the Pokes. They expect a very disciplined Chips defense at all levels. Compared them a little bit to Bill Snyder's defense at Kansas State. That's a great compliment.
On third and eight, it's Justice Hill in the backfield. Rudolph goes through his progression, takes a shot down the field. Incomplete, but the flag is thrown. Pass interference. Amari Coleman on the coverage of James Washington.
Pass interference. Defense. Number seven, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And if that ball is thrown a little bit further, it's a touchdown. It was underthrown, and Coleman was beaten so soundly by Washington, he had to stop it. And Coleman did the best thing he could possibly do, knowing that Washington is great at going up and getting the ball. He takes a hold of his arms and takes the penalty, but the flag is better than hearing the other team's fight song. So live to fight another day for the Chips.
So now first and 10 into Chippewa territory at the 47. Completes the pass to McCluskey. Malik Fountain able to bring him down. No gain on the play, second down and 10. Chris Carson back in at tailback. Stop. Quick pass again, high to McCluskey, and McCluskey will get taken down hit it right away by Alex Briones, a pickup of one. A couple of high throws early on by Rudolph to McCleskey.
And what they're doing is really working the perimeter, and you're also seeing the Chippewas defense playing very tight and very aggressive. That's going to leave them susceptible to deep plays like the one you saw almost completed to Washington that turned out to the penalty in this first down. Now it's third.
Second, third, and long of this drive. The last one resulted in that pass interference. Third and nine. Rudolph, high throw, nearly picked off by Amari Coleman. The intended receiver was Austin Hayes. So the defense for the Chippewas does the job.
And Hayes was open. You're going to see that window right there. And he could have found Hayes. He was going to have to protect himself from taking a big hit from Cox. But again, an errant throw a little bit by Mason Rudolph. And that's about three.
Zach Seiner on to punt. Emmett Thomas is back deep. Central Michigan has two returners wearing number three. Emmett Thomas, the punt returner, will wear three. And Mark Chapman, number three, will wait for kickoffs. And a fair catch is made at the 14-yard line. Well, we've seen Mason Rudolph. When we come back, we'll see our first look of Cooper.
Describe this Chippewas offense as a 90s style. Well, you can't have a 90s style offense without a fullback. And look out for Jordan Stearns, a great tackling safety, one of the best in the Big 12, has reached the 100 tackle mark in a season before.
Devin Spaulding in the backfield. Cooper Rush under center. The handoff is to Spaulding, able to dive forward up to the 15, gets 2 yards. Jordan Burton on the tackle. Cooper Rush, the active NCAA leader in career passing yards, approaching 9,600 yards. A guy with great knowledge of the game, a real student of the game. Second down and eight. His first pass attempt, and a nice catch is made by Tyler Conklin, one of his tight ends, a pickup of five. Sets up third and manageable.
Conklin, another experienced player. They have a lot of them littered all over the offensive line, out in the perimeter. Devin Spaulding back from an injury. It's a pretty big third down for the Chippewas. They need to keep pushing the ball. As you can see, they huddle up. Their style is drastically different from what Oklahoma State does. And possessing the ball is going to really help their defense in this game.
Third and three. You talk about the importance of this play. Battle of field position. And an early timeout is taken here by Central Michigan, facing a third and three.
First time out of the half. This will also be a media timeout. Timeout on the field.
Well, Tim O'Day just told you. It's immediate. It's officially third and two. And before the timeout, we saw the fullback, Joe Bocci, in. And he is in there with Devin Spaulding behind him. Play action. The pass is low. It's broken up. Chad Whitener got a piece of it.
And good job in coverage by Whitener, returning starter, and a good mic. I like the play call. Everybody expected that isolation play. We saw the fullback. You know Oklahoma State saw the fullback. They faked it and tried to run a play action out of it and get it to Jesse Kroll, but a good job by Whitener recognizing that ball. Rushed through it low so Kroll could get down and get it, but it didn't bother Whitener.
On to punt is Cooper Moshiengo. Jalen McCleskey. Fair catch called and made at the 32-yard line. These two coaches coaching at their alma mater. Bonamigo, quarterback and wide receiver, graduated in 1987. Mike Gundy, the quarterback, graduated in 1990. In his 12th season as the head coach, of course, Mike Gundy, he had a couple of good options at running back to hand the ball off to.
A couple. Barry Sanders was okay. Thurman Thomas and all right. There's still a lot of people walking around Stillwater that I talked to this week and say Mike Gundy is the best quarterback still in the history of OSU. And with that Oklahoma waterfall falling down the back of his shoulders, how can you argue?
Well, you mentioned Barry Sanders. Now Barry J. Sanders, a transfer from Stanford, in at running back on first down. Rudolph gets sacked. Sacked by number 98, Kelby Lotta.
Great job by Lotta, and he's got the size usually that you would see in the Big 12, and he does that against the center, Brand Lundblade, who was lined up against him one-on-one. Lotta is a captain of this team, along with the other defensive tackle, Jabari Dean, and they're facing two pretty inexperienced guards for Oklahoma State.
A loss of 8 on the sack. On second down, the quick pass to McCleskey is complete. But Josh Cox, with his fourth tackle already, has come up big here in this first quarter.
Corners have been playing very aggressive, and they are not backing down at all, and not afraid of getting beat deep. They plan a little bit of press.
Third and 13 coming up here for Oklahoma State. Rudolph forced out of the pocket, on the run, throws towards the sideline, incomplete. The intended receiver was Juwan Seals, so a quick three and out here for the Cowboys.
Rudolph wanted to get the ball to Seals deep. He was up against Sean Bunting, a second string corner for CMU, and Bunting was pressed on him and just wouldn't let him go. And good pass rush again, flushing Rudolph out of the pocket.
Zach Seiner on for his second punt. Emmett Thomas. Says clear out of the way, and this is going to go out of bounds. Let's see where they mark it out at the 32. There is a flag down in the backfield. It's a 43-yard punt. This is back where Seiner, the punter, was. There are a couple flags there.
That's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
That is a costly, costly penalty.
Well, there you see him. He's going to leave his feet. Can't do that taking on those personal protectors anymore. And that's a penalty. Bonamigo's not going to like that, especially an old-school special teams guy like he is. And you want to have guys sell out, but you have to have them sell out smart.
Zach Oakley called for that penalty. Let's bring in Mike Pereira, joining us from LA. Mike, about that rule and that call, if you can explain it further for us.
Yeah, we saw that initially on the live shot. When you've got a three-man shield in front like that, or any shield, you cannot leave your feet and attempt to jump that shield. And if you do and make contact, it's a personal foul. It's a good call.
Here on first down, it's Chris Carson picking up 8 yards. And so let's see what happens here with Oklahoma State getting a second opportunity. A lost shoe. That's now down by the 40. It's Chris Carson going with one shoe. Rudolph pressured up the middle, trying to escape, and he slides. And he gets hit going down by Nathan Ricketts. He'll get one.
Carson and the one shoe is actually open on the outlet for Rudolph. He just didn't have time to get over there. Good pressure again. And that's a 6'5" quarterback against a really active Will linebacker. Good job of Rudolph getting down.
Pass on the slant. That one's popped loose. And they're going to say it's incomplete. In and out of the hands of Jalen McCleskey.
On the previous play with incomplete pass.
And this is Tony Anise that makes this play, just a ball hawk safety. Heart and soul of the defense, and he just dislodges that ball beautifully. And they force another punt.
A And Zach Seiner on to punt again with Emmett Thomas back at his own 8-yard line this time. Fair catch, called for, made at the 15. So they would have had the ball at the 32 before the penalty. Now they'll have it at the 15 after a 33-yard punt. No score here in the first quarter. Central Michigan and number 22, Oklahoma State.
We got married in June.
On Tuna Day. There's a Subway 350 sub of the day to help you remember.
Mike Hill.
Austin Houston up the number 6 in the polls after that big win over Oklahoma last week hosting Lamar. Greg Ward Jr. out with a shoulder injury, more precautionary on the short week. So Kyle Postma doing his thing at quarterback. 39-yard TD run, and it's the Cougs up 7-0 early in the first.
All right, Mike, here is Central Michigan starting at their own 15. On first down, it's Devin Spalding trying to cut it back, and he's going to lose a couple of yards. Ramon Richards, who had a touchdown last week on a lateral, gets the tackle for a loss here.
Very athletic player Richards is, and he gambles a little bit. And he came flying in there on the pitch play and made a good play on the legs of Devin Spalding.
Second and 12 here for CMU. Rush swings it out to Spalding. Again, tries to cut it back. He'll get a yard. Jordan Stearns, one of the leaders of this defense, the leader of the secondary for Oklahoma State, makes the tackle.
And that's what great safeties do. It looked for a moment like Spalding had some field in front of him, but a guy like Jordan Stearns, a great tackler, zeroes in, gets that missile lock on you, and you're finished.
Cooper Rush facing third and 11. Deep in his own territory. Jesse Kroll in motion. Flag on the play. Rush throws it. Incomplete. And he got hit. Kenneth Edison Magruder with the contact against Cooper Rush.
Illegal motion, offense number 88. That penalty is declined, fourth down.
Man, so it's illegal motion and Cooper Rush took that hit.
Nice safety blitz dialed up there by Edison Magruder. Just comes in and gets a clear shot on the ribs of Rush. And Rush had to park the punt, Rush the throw.
Now Cooper Moshiengo once again will punt, this time from his own end zone, with Jalen McCleskey at his own 40. Fair catch again signaled and made at the 43. A 42-yard punt. Oklahoma
needed to do, but they've been out there a long time and they've been tired. James Washington there wants to bust one deep because these guys have been playing it pretty tight, although they're off him right now.
Starting at their own 43. On first down, delayed handoff to Justice Hill, trying to spin away from a tackle. Could not. Malik Fountain was there. Wrapped him up at the ankle. So 1 yard pickup.
Fountain's been very good getting there in the Mike Backer position on these zone running plays for the post.
Second down and 9. Pump fake. Rudolph taking the shot down the field. Chris Lacy can't catch up to it. Amari Coleman was beat by Lacy. But it's 3rd and 9.
And that is the second deep ball that was wide open that Mason Rudolph has missed. The first one was underthrown to Washington, and they had the pass interference penalty, and that one overthrown to Lacy. Rudolph been a little bit off in this game.
Just 18 yards on 6 completions. Quick math, that's 3 yards per completion. 3rd and 9. Rudolph checks it down to Carson. Carson able to jump over Sean Bunting for the first down.
And you got to give that one to the Oklahoma State offensive line, giving Rudolph a lot of time to work all his progression all the way over to the left side to his outlet in the back. Good, good time for Rudolph.
A 13-yard completion to Carson. And now into CMU territory at the 43. Rudolph throws, completes to Washington. Well, Petrus, you had said as we were in the break that this could be trouble for Central Michigan because their defense might be tired. And here is Oklahoma State going fast. A quick pass to McCleskey. Gets a block. McCleskey down the sideline. Stays in. Or does he not? Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
Still waiting for the signal.
Thank you.
This is what they do. They play fast. They get a first down. They get you a little bit discombobulated. They get it to McCleskey. The chips aren't all the way set up, and he finds the sideline, and it looks like he was able to tow it all the way into the orange.
Ben Grogan on for the extra point. I'm still waiting for the signal. Yard completion to McCleskey. And that is his first touchdown of the year. 5 plays, 57 yards.
And Rudolph, not super sharp in this first quarter, but all it takes is one first down and they line up and get you. Really nice block.
It looked like he was out.
Maybe that's why we didn't see the signal, but it's too late now. Chris Lacy with a great block there on the edge, springing McCleskey to the sideline.
Oklahoma State may have gotten away with one right there.
You see how quickly the rhythm of the game can change if you're not able to get a first down or two offensively to give your defense a second to collect themselves. We're going to watch this again with McCleskey on the edge. And right there, looks like he could have stepped out. There's no doubt the officials were a little bit concerned about it because we didn't see an immediate touchdown signal.
Max Allen will do the kickoff duties here. Mark Chapman is back deep for Central Michigan. Chapman from the five. He gets stood up at the 20, a 15-yard return. Well, college football continues next year on FS1 as SMU takes on number 23 Baylor. Then later tonight, the rivalry continues when BYU faces Utah at 7 Eastern on Fox, while North Carolina battles Illinois on Big Ten Network. Then the Texas Tech Red Raiders go up against Arizona State at 10 p.m. Eastern, again here on FS1. Well, Cooper Rush off to a slow start, 2 for 4 for just 7 yards for Central Michigan as his Chippewas now trail 7-0.
And talking to Glenn Spencer, the great defensive coordinator for Oklahoma State, he said they expect Cooper Rush to complete balls. They expect these guys to move the ball. Hasn't happened yet.
Jarre Hayes is now in at tailback. Well, play action rolling out for Rex. His Rush throws towards the sideline, completes the pass. A flag is thrown. Corey Willis makes the reception. It's an 8-yard completion. Let's wait to see what the flag is for.
Corey Willis had to work pretty hard to get away from that corner.
Pass interference. Offense, number 8. Half the distance to the goal. still first down.
He was working too hard. Looks like he was working so hard they called a PI on him. Ramon Richards with the very aggressive bump on him at first. And they're going to call a push off there. I can understand why they called it, but they were physical with each other during the whole round. There's Coach Spencer, ninth season at Oklahoma State.
I loved what he said to us yesterday. They care about points per possession, getting the ball back for the offense, turnovers, and field position, and don't worry about giving up yards. First and 20 now for Central Michigan. Rush, low throw, hit as he's thrown. Jordan Burton able to take down Cooper Rush.
Burton, first team all Big 12 in 2015, getting in that backfield, and he's not the only one. A lot of blitzes being piled up. That's John Ray Hayes at running back that was supposed to pick him up, but just got trucked by Burton. You have to do a better job picking up blitz. That's probably why Devin Spaulding is the starter most of the time, because he's just better at picking up blitz for these guys. But they haven't established their running backs at all.
Spaulding is back in. They swing it out to him. Spaulding with some room down the sideline. A good job by Lindsey Pipkins to get out and make the tackle. The grad transfer from Louisiana Monroe. Started 22 games for Louisiana Monroe. Makes that tackle. And now third and 12 coming up.
Derek Edwards, the right tackle, just kind of fell down in front of Lindsey Pipkins, and he was able to edge Spaulding out of bounds. This is huge for the Chips. They've just had no success offensively. They've been on this side of the field all game.
On third and long, screen pass. That's batted down at the line. It was actually hit the back of the helmet of the center, Austin Doan. So now Central Michigan is 0 for 3 on third downs. And Glenn Spencer loves what his defense is doing.
He said, don't get flustered when this guy completes balls, but they're not letting Cooper Rush complete any balls. That one hits right in the back of the head, Austin Doan, and they were trying to run a little screen with the tailback coming back across the middle, what we used to call a Texas route in the 90s. And it might have gone if it didn't hit that guy in the head.
Oshiengo, a low punt, just got it away. McCleskey backs up. This will roll and be down at the 37-yard line, a 46-yard punt. Well, every weekday morning, Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp go head-to-head on the day's hottest sports topics. Undisputed with Skip and Shannon, weekdays at 9:30 a.m. Eastern, 6:30 a.m. Pacific, only on FS1. 7-0 Oklahoma State leading Central Michigan on what some could say was a controversial touchdown to Jalen McCleskey. But it doesn't matter. It's now 7-0 Oklahoma State. Mason Rudolph back out there with Rennie Childs in the backfield. Play action. Rudolph with time. Throws to Washington. Completes it. And Washington is across the 35, down the 31. A 28-yard completion. And Rudolph is saying, hurry up.
And this is the route that got him going on the last drive. That deep cross by Washington. Nice throw.
Kept by Rudolph. And he gets tackled by Amari Coleman.
Here's Washington's route. You're going to see it. Very good route runner. Just comes right across that deep cross. He has plenty of cushion from Amari Coleman, and that ball was delivered.
On 2nd and 10, Rudolph pressured, gets out of the pocket, throws to McCleskey, and McCleskey picks up the first down, is out at the 18.
You're starting to see the fatigue of the Chips, and all of those perimeter throws, all of the stuff they were doing, even when they weren't having success, Oklahoma State was getting these guys to run to the sideline, and now they're gassed.
Rudolph, the pump fake over the middle, caught, touchdown! Zach Veach, 18-yard touchdown catch.
It all comes from the rhythm of the offense, and you feel the beat of it. Here comes Beach, not a bad route off the line of scrimmage. Nobody reroutes him, and he's a big target for Rudolph. Rudolph's starting to find his groove and his rhythm, getting the ball delivered in a much more efficient way than he was earlier in the first quarter.
Ben Grogan, the extra point. 14 quick points here for Oklahoma State. They went 63 yards in just 47 seconds. Winslow Chapman tried to take down Zach Veach, but at 265, that was going to bring down the big man. 190 versus 265, 265 wins. That's like me hitting you.
Generally. Hey, I've lost a little weight, but I have been 265. I tell you what.
I'm not 190 either.
you've got, we pump up the stats like any good media guy. You've got to give all the credit to the Oklahoma State defense for these 14 points in the first quarter. Their offense came out and looked a little bit messy. Rudolph was throwing balls high. They couldn't get the run game going. The paddle people love this. They like to see that offensive rhythm. But it really has started with CMU's offense getting nothing from Oklahoma State's D. 15 yards and zero first downs in the first quarter for the Chips offense, and that is not what they're used to. But I tell you what, that guy loves it.
And the defense for Oklahoma State rarely gets credit because people always talk about the offense, how quick the tempo is and this and that.
And they think about Mike Gundy, who played quarterback here, and it is a unique offense, but it doesn't work without the defense, without having a bunch of guys ready to go, especially on the back end, and stay fresh, because those guys are on the field a lot more than they normally would be in a conventional football game, but football's changing.
Max Allen to kick off. Mark Chapman is back. Chapman will get a chance to return again, this time from the six. Takes a hit, gets up to the 21-yard line. And let's see if Central Michigan can get some type of offense going. Because it's not just for him, but his defense needs it.
They need it bad. They're sitting on the sideline hoping that they can take a few more breaths than they have been able to with all these three and outs. Montemigo knows Cooper Rush is a very experienced player. So if there's one guy that's not going to get flustered in this situation, in this environment, down 14 when you haven't had that much success, it's this quarterback. Let's see if he can pull it together while the defense rests.
Devin Spaulding in the backfield. Rush under center. Cooper Rush open his crawl down the sideline. They've got a first down. A 12-yard completion. Jordan Burton knocks Kroll out of bounds.
And that was similar to the action that they ran on the third and short in their first drive, except it was to the left side instead of the right. And just a good job of getting Kroll open and doing something easy to get this offense back in a little bit of a rhythm.
The first down of the day for Central Michigan.
This play action's not going to work that much unless they establish a run game, and they've yet to do that.
And they've got their fullback, Joe Bocci, in. Play action again. Rush taking the shot down the field for Cole, and it's knocked away. He had it in his hands. Jordan Stearns knocked it away. Lindsey Pipkins was there on the coverage.
Just a little late from Cooper Rush. He's able to load up and throw it. Got to slow down. Kroll does just a little bit, and a good job by Pipkins attacking the ball. You see that? And Stearns then attacking the ball with his face and both arms. That's how you make sure it's dislodged. Good defense.
Second down and 10 now for Central Michigan. Willis. Able to avoid a big hit. Gets 6 yards. Trey Flowers, Vincent Taylor combined for the tackle.
And I've been pretty impressed so far in this game with this defense. They've been very quick to the ball, even when the screens have been set up, and it looks like they have a bit of a chance. These Oklahoma State guys have closed on all three levels and really made it hard so far on the Chips. And here's another third down, and there's so much play action we're seeing from them, but they've not established anything in the run.
Third and four. They're 0 for 3 on third downs today. Rush steps up over the middle, and there is the first third down conversion. Eric Cooper on the catch to midfield, 11 yards.
This was a little bit more honest, just a straight drop. Over route there by Cooper. And you can see Rush starting to relax a little bit now in this drive.
Just about 30 seconds to go here in the opening quarter. 14-0, Oklahoma State on top. What a catch by Willis.
That takes a lot of courage. You know somebody's right there, and he's leading you right into the defender. Jordan Burton, one of the toughest hitters out there, has been trucking people all in the first quarter. And Willis goes right into him.
And that will be the final play of this first quarter.
That's the end of the first quarter. Timeout on the field.
Oklahoma State leading Central Michigan. Couple of... Get those headphones on. Look away if you're a fan of running the football.
Gosh,
turn
I can't.
Away.
I have to work here. No rushing yards for the Chips, and they need them bad. And Oklahoma State's still trying to find that back.
Jare Hayes is in. Cooper Rush throwing, completes the pass. Tyler Conklin, one of his tight ends, makes the catch. Down to the 27-yard line, a 19-yard completion.
Big hits from that secondary. Two great safeties from Oklahoma State. Really making people pay. But like we said, there's a lot of experience here in this Central Michigan perimeter. And they're used to catching balls from Cooper Rush and taking hits.
Rush over the middle, another completion. This time it's to Hayes for 7 yards.
Throwing the ball a lot out of the backfield. Jare Hayes, much more solid in the program this year than he was last year. Came from City College in San Francisco. Another good target for Cooper Rush, finding him over the middle.
Second down and three. Bocci is in at fullback. They're going to hand it off to Hayes up the middle. And Hayes has the first down of the 14, gets six.
Now this is exactly who Central Michigan is as a football team. Watch number 40 go in motion and then lead. Picks up a D lineman who came clean. That's Mote Maile that he took out. And a nice physical run by Jare Hayes, who scored 3 touchdowns last week. Usually you want the fullback to lead on a linebacker, but he saw that defensive lineman coming clean with a chance to make the tackle. Great adjustment by Bocci.
First and 10, Rush drops back, throws towards the end zone. It's broken up by Jordan Stearns, who was looking for Coplin. And Jordan Stearns, again, really nicely done breaking that one up.
Now, I knew about his tackling ability and his leadership ability, but I'm pretty impressed with Stern so far in this game with his coverage ability. Beautifully leaving his feet. Big hit on Cooper Rush as well.
Vincent Taylor delivered the blow on Cooper Rush. Jordan Stern's back-to-back season with 100 tackles for Oklahoma State. Last year, 103 in 2014. Rush on 2nd and 10, pressured, and he goes down. It's Traylon Weber sacking him for a loss of 11.
Very good pressure coming right up the middle. That's Joe Austin. Traylon Weber. Joe Austin really getting beat.
It's Balding in that tailback on third and 20. Rush stepping up. Lost one. Caught to the end zone. Touchdown, Tyler Coughlin on third and 20. What a big answer by Central Michigan.
And what poise by Cooper Rush. Here the pocket breaks down as it had, and he got sacked in the last down. And watch him scramble and keep his eyes upfield. There's a lot of green in front of him, but he knows he's not going to make it. He keeps his eyes upfield and finds Coughlin. Coughlin does a good job of finishing the run and getting into the end zone. What a play. What poise by Rush.
A 24-yard touchdown pass to Coughlin. And now Brian Eby on for the extra point. And it's a 14-7 ball game. 11 plays, 79 yards, 5:05 off the clock. A touch pass for his tight end. 14-7, Oklahoma State leading Central Michigan.
On the first few drives of the game, as opposed to the one that started giving up big yards to this Oklahoma State offense when they got tired. That was the answer they needed. Things were getting a little bit desperate here for the Chips, and Cooper Rush, like we said, very poised, a guy that knows what he's doing, was not going to get flustered in this situation, led his team down the field, and they still haven't established much of a run game.
Brian Eby to kick off with Chris Lacy and Jeff Carr back. They go with a short kick. And it's taken back to the 34-yard line, a 9-yard return. Time for a game break. Let's go back and check with Mike Hill.
All right, guys, number 5, Michigan putting a hammer on Central Florida today. Wilton Spate going up top, finding Amara Darbo. 45 yards, gets some 6. Wolverine special teams with 2 blocked punts and a blocked field goal already in this one. It's all Wolverines, 24-0 in the second. Justin Petros, back to you.
All right, thanks, Mike. Let's see what Oklahoma State will do now with Chris Carson in the backfield, starting at the 33 officially. On first down, that's a lateral to McCleskey. And McCleskey with that speed gets up to the 41-yard line. Josh Cox with his 6th tackle already, an 8-yard pickup. Second and 2.
I like Jalen McCleskey. 4-4-40 guy, fastest player on the roster. Great little slot receiver for the Pokes.
Hand off on second and 2 to Justice Hill, and Hill hits that hole and gets the first down to the 48-yard line. Nathan Ricketts with the tackle, a pickup of 7 for Hill.
They did tell us Justice Hill is their best angles runner, got very good cutback vision, and he just made a little subtle move there to get the first down without having to take a big hit. Pretty impressive.
A standout in camp. 7 carries, 30 yards last week in the victory over Southeastern Louisiana. Play action. Rudolph with time, plenty of time. Now he throws, and it's dropped by Dylan Stoner, the true freshman.
Stoner is another slot guy, kind of playing behind McCleskey, a true freshman from Jenks High School in Tulsa, really a do-it-all star, and he was open as the outlet for about 5 good seconds, and I just think he waited so long. When the ball finally came, he lost his concentration.
On second down and 10, Barry J. Sanders comes in at tailback. Rudolph gets rid of it to Washington with a couple of blockers. Washington gets dragged down from behind, but not before he gets the first down. Tony Anise with the tackle, 11-yard pickup for Washington.
And that's going to be there for Washington, I would imagine, in a lot of games this year for Oklahoma State. Here's a guy that can go deep, really go up and get it, the biggest receiver threat in the Big 12. And there's going to be a lot of very, very soft coverage on him. If you can find him a hitch and he can run the ball like that, that's a good play on first down.
Rudolph forced out, dumps it off to Sanders, who gets wrapped up by Winslow Chapman. A pickup of just 1 second and nine. Delayed handoff. Sanders couldn't escape the tackle of Alex Briones. He gets four, but if not for Briones, could have been a lot more.
Yeah, Nathan Ricketts involved there as well. I like this linebacker play from all three of the starters for the Chips. Nathan Ricketts, Malik Fountain, and Alex Briones have all made pretty good plays running sideline to sideline. Keeping them fresh, I really think, is the key for Coach Bonamigo.
Now third and five. The 36, you wonder if it's two down territory. If they don't get it, they're going for it right here. Down the sideline, jump ball. And there on the coverage was Amari Coleman against James Washington.
Here you are, Amari Coleman, one of the better corners in the MAC, taking on the best receiver in the Big 12. Ball's underthrown. Washington never had a chance to use his physicality and catch the ball over him. And that's maybe the third poorly thrown deep ball we've seen from Rudolph, and good job by the Chips. They forced a field goal.
Now Matt Amendola is going to come on for what would be a 53-yard field goal attempt. Trying to bend it in, and that is good. Wow, just getting it in. That's right, Matt, you can celebrate the freshman. From 53,
we thought they would go for it on fourth down, but they had that big leg hiding on the bench. And here he comes, a redshirt freshman.
And watch the celebration. From outside of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, fired up. That's awesome to see. He was smiling during the entire commercial break, and rightfully so. And now Max Allen on for the kickoff with Jonathan Ward, the true freshman, back deep for Central Michigan. 17-7 ball game, second quarter. And this goes out of bounds, and good starting field position now for Central Michigan. And Cooper Rush kind of hit his stride on that last drive.
Yeah, he was all the things that we were told: sturdy, smart, reliable. Not going to get flustered if the situation is bad, and that was beautiful. Just the touch pass, keeping his eyes up the field on the rush on a big third down. Nice answer from Central Michigan, and a good job there forcing a field goal. 53 yards, great job by Amendola. If he could make it, go ahead and try it.
Yeah, fourth longest field goal in Oklahoma State history. So now, after the kick out of bounds, Central Michigan will start at the 35-yard line. And we saw the answer, the last drive by Cooper Rush. What will he have in store on this drive?
Whatever they do, they have to find somebody to get them a little bit of cushion in the run game, because Rush is getting hit a little too much.
Devin Spaulding in the backfield, play action on first down. He gets hit again, but he completes the pass to Jesse Kroll, who gets shoved out of bounds. A pickup of seven, so second and three, Ashton Lampkin pushes him out.
Great pressure again from Vincent Taylor. One of the most experienced defensive linemen in Mike Gundy's tenure, believe it or not, at Oklahoma State.
And Taylor had five sacks last year, the highest for an interior lineman under Mike Gundy. Joe Bocci in motion. A carry for Spaulding. Tries to turn upfield. He does enough to get four in the first down. Calvin Bundage, the true freshman from Edmond, Oklahoma, makes the tackle.
And every time these run plays or these screens develop for Central Michigan, it looks like, and that was good enough for a first down, but it always looks like there's a little bit more there. Very impressed with the speed of Glenn Spencer's defense. They get to people very quickly and get them down. These guys run very well, and you would expect that in a league like the Big 12.
Hey, Rush, a quick out to Kroll. He'll get nine. Ramon Richards brings him down, so second and one. A flag is down in the backfield.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, number 99, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
That's against Trey Carter, the sophomore of Dallas, Texas.
Starting to see his first playing time there. You see him right here, right-hand side defensive end. And just the hand right to the face immediately.
Getting together to talk about the penalty.
Pass, the 15-yard penalty be added to the end of the run, first down.
It's a huge play for Central Michigan.
That now becomes a 24-yard play, essentially. And the ball goes all the way down to the 25-yard line of Oklahoma State. So now you look at the last two drives for Central Michigan, and kind of what you're expecting, Petros. This team is not phased at all. They're not scared. They've answered. They took those first couple of punches, and they've responded now. Hand off to Spaulding up the middle. Chad Whitener with a tackle, a four-yard run for Devin Spaulding up the middle. Second down and six.
This is what they want to do. They want to do things to make Oklahoma State feel maybe a little bit complacent or just tired out there, wondering why they're being left out there for so long. These guys are going to run the ball on first down for 1 yard and 2 yards, and that's okay. It's part of this offense. It's kind of a slow-rolling offense.
Second and six, rush, pressure, escapes, has some room, and he dives forward, saw the first down marker, able to dive forward and get the first down. A 10-yard little scramble for Cooper Rush.
Somebody got a hold of his neck, somebody jumped over him. All kinds of action there in the backfield, and he's able to escape with that 6'3", 230-pound frame. Looked like he was going to slide for a moment, but like you said, Justin, I think he saw the marker and he lurched forward. Nice play. He's great in the red zone. Cooper Rush really knows what he's doing.
That's what all these starts will do for you. First and 10 from the 13. Rush. Throws, completes it to Kroll, spins, and Kroll is taken down inside the five by Ramon Richards and Jordan Burton.
I'm down here close. It's a second and short. What do you think Central Michigan's going to do? They might try to run the ball here, but remember, they used a lot of play action over the last few series to kind of try to lull this Oklahoma State team.
They've got Bocci in at fullback. Don't forget they use their tight ends a lot. It is the handoff to Spaulding. And let's see where the forward progress is. He may have enough for that first down. And they do. So they get the first down. It's going to be first and goal.
And even though that didn't seem like there was a lot to the play, watch Bocci come back across the quarterback and knock out a defensive lineman. That is very difficult to do for any quarterback. That was Darian Daniels he got a chip on. And just enough to get Spaulding that first down. That allows a fresh set of downs right on the three. Central Michigan can do what they want with Morris Watts, their offensive coordinator, can dial up a lot of different things here.
First and goal from the three. Spaulding trying to cut back, kind of slipped, lost his footing. Ramon Richards hit him. No gain on the play. Second and goal, even lost a yard. So it's going to be second and goal from the four.
And I don't usually like a pitch this close to the goal line, and maybe they were trying to catch Oklahoma State off guard or catch him in some kind of interior stunt, but too much penetration coming from this Cowboys defense to try to get something on the perimeter.
On second and goal, looking for the fade, and it's incomplete. They were looking for Conklin again. It was Jordan Stearns on the coverage. You don't want to throw to this guy. That's three pass breakups in this game already.
Here he is, one-on-one against a tight end. And his vision and seeing the ball and doing those things has been just impeccable in this game thus far. And his tackling is really the strength of what he does. Jordan Stearns, the absolute locker room champion, they say. The most loyal player maybe in the history of Stillwater football.
This will also be a media timeout. Timeout on the field.
Timeout taken by Central Michigan, facing a third and goal from the four, down by 10 here in the second quarter. Rob, thank you very much. Looking forward to that coming up at the half. But right now, we've got a third and goal coming up here for Central Michigan. Trailing by 10. A fumble on the snap. Cooper Rush picks it up and then gets tackled by Monte Milet. After the timeout, how about that?
Opportunistic play by Miley, no doubt, but Cooper Rush is not going to be pleased with this looking on film. He had to take his eyes off the snap. It was just a little low, but he didn't secure it completely and dropped it, and that might cost him points.
So now it's Brian Eby on from 24 yards out to make it a seven-point game once again.
Delay game, kicking team, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
That's two big mistakes in a row for the Chippewas, and that is uncharacteristic of a team that has so much experience. Why the ball wasn't snapped, I'm just not sure.
So now you go from 24 now to 29 yards on the attempt.
Maybe it was too close for him.
And Eby drills it from 29. We do have ourselves a ball game here in Stillwater, 17-10 Oklahoma State.
In the second.
Back here in Stillwater under blue sky, 17-10 Oklahoma State over Central Michigan. The two teams exchanging field goals on their last possessions. Brian Eby will kick off with Chris Lacy and Jeff Carr back deep. Eby just drilled that 29-yard field goal to make it a seven-point game. And this will go out of bounds as well, so it will be Oklahoma State ball at the 35. Mason Rudolph got off to a slow start, 6 of 9 for 18 yards, but then picked it up. Now 14 of 20, 149. Cooper Rush also slow, but he too has picked it up of late, up over 100 yards for a touchdown. He was able to find his tight end, Tyler Conklin, for a score. And this game has picked up as well, 17-10.
The Pokes have had the most success on offense when the Chippewas defense has been out there a long time. The last three possessions, you see, touchdown, touchdown, field goal, that was after all the three and outs from Cooper Rush. Now that the defense has had a little more time to rest, the last time they forced a field goal, let's see if they're back to what they were earlier in the game.
Delayed handoff to Carson up the middle, trying to slip by a tackle, can't do it. It's Nathan Ricketts who makes that ankle tackle, a 5-yard run for Chris Carson. Play action. Rudolph over the middle. Throws high for McCleskey. Incomplete. And now third and five coming up. And all of a sudden, if Central Michigan can force a three and out here with 3:48 to go, you've got a chance to put some more points on the board.
Yeah, right before the half. And they kind of lulled them into that, didn't
and
they?
And guess what? They get the kickoff to open up the third quarter.
Central Michigan, very poised. They know each other. They have a blue-collar attitude. They trust each other. They're not going to buckle out here.
On third and five, Rudolph pressured up the middle, gets rid of it. And they force the three and out. Nate Brisson Fast got the pressure on Mason Rudolph.
You see him coming from that defensive tackle position. Small pass rushing specialist right by Marcus Keys with kind of a club and rip move, and just gets onto the waist of Mason Rudolph. Lucky that he got it off.
Zach Seiner to punt. Emmett Thomas back at his own 10. A low kick. Muff punt. And it's recovered at the 10-yard line by Ray Golden. Golden just saves Central Michigan.
Golden, wow. Opportunity for that young man. Look at that. Just falls right on the ball in a situation that could have been disastrous. And like we said, that Oklahoma State offense, when they don't have the tired Chippewas defense up against them, they just don't look the same. Another three and out. The Chippewas forced it. Here he comes again. The coolest guy in Stillwater, Cooper Rush, just very calm and very impressed with his ability to just stay the course in this game.
Well, it's funny. You talked about that tired Chippewa defense. Well, now it's a tired Cowboys defense and a veteran quarterback who has kind of hit his stride with 3:33 to go, has to go the length of the field, one timeout remaining for Central Michigan.
And, you know, this is one of the things we talked to Glenn Spencer about, the defensive coordinator of Oklahoma State, before the game. They're used to playing a lot of defense because of the way the Oklahoma State offense plays. They score fast, they move, but at the same time, he's got to have 10 guys in the secondary ready to roll all the way through. And they could be susceptible in that way because not every guy, you know, there's a reason a guy's a second string guy.
It's the handoff to Chapman, who is in motion. And Chapman gets bumped out by Stearns, but not before he picks up seven. Second down and three coming up.
Central's been working the perimeter a little bit more than I thought they would. You heard Matt Leiner talking before the game about how they're really going to have to stay inside because Oklahoma State is so fast on both sides of the ball on the perimeter. But they've not been afraid to run pitches, and there you saw the fly sweep to Chapman. Maybe it'll open up some gaps in the A and B gap a little later in the game for Spalding to run through.
Spalding in the backfield on second and three. A low pass. It is complete for the first down. Chapman was able to go down and get it. The clock stopped momentarily as they reset the chains.
Yeah, good job by Chapman getting both arms under it and adjusting after the ball was tipped. That's a very difficult thing to do.
John Bonamigo, his team led last year in the third quarter of that game. 13-10, Cooper Rush towards the sideline, completes another pass. And he completes it this time to Jesse Kroll for 18 yards.
And did you see, that's a little bit more of this blue collar mentality of this team. Rush takes another big shot, but look at Kroll, catches the ball on the sideline, could step out of bounds easily right there. No, turns up and takes a big hit from Jordan Stearns, the angry safety, and Lindsey Pipkins. Great job by Kroll. I really liked watching him in the first half. He's been very reliable for his quarterback.
You know, it's funny because John Bonamigo, Morris Watts, the offensive coordinator, when asked about Cooper Rush, they said he will stand in the pocket. He's got great pocket presence. He'll stand in there. He'll take the hit. He has done just that today. Comes near sideline to Anthony Rice for his first catch of the day. Gets 4 yards. Second down and six. Ramon Richards, Jordan Burton combined to bring him down.
I'd wear number 82 if my last name was Rice. I wouldn't let anybody say it. I just hope they made a mistake and think I was him.
Second and six. Tyree Hayes in the backfield now. Play action. Rush. Again towards the sideline. It is Kroll who makes the catch. Shoved out of bounds by Lindsey Pipkins.
Now that's five catches for Kroll now for over 50 yards in the first half. He's been very good.
Don't forget, coming up next, the State Farm Halftime Show with Rob Stone and the guys. They'll talk about this one. It's a good game. Central Michigan trying to get some points on the board before the half comes to a close. Third and four coming up. Rush off the back foot, just throws it up. There was some contact, no flags. Intended receiver Corey Willis.
I think that was a good no call. I don't think that was a catchable ball. It was a prayer thrown by Cooper Rush. Ashton Lampkin there on the coverage. And I don't even know if Willis knew where he was going on that route. It was definitely going to be an adjustment by him to try to get down the field. And look, there's a minute left. If you got Oklahoma State and Mason Rudolph taking over, that's a tough call.
And they've got three timeouts remaining. Cooper Moshienko will punt. McCleskey is back. An angled punt towards the sideline. And it'll be down inside the 15-yard line. A 43-yard punt by Moshienko. Under a minute to go now for Mason Rudolph. And we already saw Matt Amendola connect from 53 yards out for Oklahoma State. So Central Michigan had their chance. Couldn't capitalize. Now can Mike Gundy's squad get a few points on the board before this first half comes to a close? Justin Kutcher, Petros Papadakis, Mike Pereira with you here for this one. Central Michigan against Oklahoma State from Boone Pickens Stadium in Stillwater, Oklahoma. On first down, Rudolph throws towards the sideline for Washington. Incomplete. He was out of bounds. Washington could not get a foot down inbounds.
James Washington might have a hard time getting down inbounds too if I could jump that high. My goodness, what an athletic move to get to that ball. But just a little bit more awareness with that toe he needed.
Delayed handoff for Carson. Breaks the tackle. Carson. Still on his feet, able to lunge forward to the 27. A 12-yard run. Winslow Chapman gets credit for the tackle.
And I think you heard a little bit of an excitement from the crowd with Carson breaking that tackle, because they don't see a lot of that. I mean, they're still looking to find an every down back on this team.
A pump fake. Rudolph with time. Comes all the way back across the field and completes the pass to Chris Lacey for three. Lacey got out of bounds, stops the clock with 36 seconds again. Three timeouts remaining for Oklahoma State. Rennie Childs now in at tailback for the Cowboys. Pressure coming. Rudolph gets sacked. Joe Ostman, who is going to be a key for this Chippewa team on defense, gets the sack.
Yeah, from St. Ignatius in Michigan, we're talking about six tackles and a sack last year. Here he is on the top of your screen, beating Victor Salenko, just with speed, and he's a little smaller than most of those guys. 6'3", 255, pass rush specialist on the weak side. And he had a huge game last year against the Pokes before he was hurt.
That'll do it for the first half. A good first half of football. Close one, 17-10. Oklahoma State on top. Now let's go to Rob Stone in L.A.
Justin Petros, thank you. We welcome you to the State Farm FS.
Huge mark of what they do offensively. He's going to have to shore that up, but he did get a couple of deep crosses to his great receiver, Washington. And this was the McCleskey touchdown, taking it to the house. They got him with tempo, finding Beach for a touchdown again. And Cooper Rush did not start the game with any kind of rhythm, but they started getting it going, even without establishing a run game. Very poised, calm young man. That was a great play as he floats it out and gets a touchdown with his eyes down to Beal.
A look at the stats from the first half. The passing yards are pretty even. The rush yards, neither team had many. And the red zone, both teams right now are perfect in the red zone. Central Michigan to receive the opening kickoff here in the third quarter. And it will be a touchback, so Central Michigan will start at the 25-yard line. Cooper Rush. What can he do to open up here? Rush 12 for 19, 116 yards and one touchdown in that. Down, it's a handoff to Spaulding, and Spaulding with his best run of the game to open up this third quarter, holding on to the ball with Oklahoma State players trying to strip it from him, picks up 17.
CMU's not going to beat themselves, but they have to establish a run game to win here. Look at Spaulding's patience there, the double jump cut and then across again with a little block on Stearns from Kroll. Nice play. Best run of the day so far for any team on the field.
Rush to throw now on first down. Had it batted down by Mote Mile. Mile, he started every game last year.
This really is one of the staples of the Oklahoma State defense. Active hands, causing turnovers, raising havoc, and Mile there with the paw up. A few batted balls in this game for Rush, and he does not throw a really sharp ball. It's more of a catchable ball, kind of a Joe Montana style, and Mile was able to get a punch on it.
Cooper Rush now 16 of 25 on the day. Second down and 10. Spaulding. Nowhere really to go. Gets a yard. Mile and Chad Whitener combined for the tackle.
Good penetration by the Pokes defense there. And Spaulding, even before he got the handoff, was trying to make a cut to the outside. And if you're trying to make a cut before you get the handoff because of penetration, that is not a good omen for the future of that run play. Big third down here. Remember, it was a third down that Cooper Rush was able to throw that touchdown pass in the red zone.
Third and 9. Jare Hayes is in on third down for CMU. Over the middle, the pass is incomplete. Anthony Rice can't hang on to it. He was going to be short of the first down marker anyway. Trey Flowers was right there.
Trey Flowers, young man out of San Antonio, good looking safety, very athletic guy, great triple jumper in high school. Right on top of the play by Rice, but the catch should have been made.
Central Michigan now 2 for 8 on third downs on the day. Cooper Mojienko on to punts. Jalen McCleskey is back at the 15. low kick. Taken at the 20 by McCleskey. McCleskey with that speed able to turn the corner and gets run out of bounds around the 35. They're going to mark him out at the 38. It's a 38-yard punt, a 17-yard return. Mason Rudolph, 15 of 24, 153 yards in that first half, a couple of touchdowns. Did not turn the ball over. McCleskey, seven catches, 50 yards, had the one touchdown. James Washington, four catches for 67 yards.
He also drew that big play nature, really.
Yeah, he also drew that pass interference. And they'll start with good field position here on their first drive of the second half. At the 38-yard line, Chris Carson in the backfield. Handoff is to Carson. Carson got hit in the backfield, tried to break free. DeAndre Dill was the first to make contact. Big number 95, the true freshman out of Chester, Pennsylvania.
And a 310-pound guy. They need those over 300-pound guys on that front to take on a Big 12 offensive line. And they are not able to break the first tackle at all, any of these running backs for Oklahoma State. You got to give the chips a...
On second down, the pass is floated to Juwan Seals, completed for 5 yards. Josh Cox with tackle number 7 on the afternoon.
Sure tackling from everybody. Real lot of credit you got to give this defense for really finding their way after getting hit with some tempo late in the first quarter.
Now third and 5. Rudolph, high pass to McCleskey, is dropped. McCleskey was hit right away by Winslow Chapman. So good defense once again by the Chippewas.
You're going to see McCleskey, he plays that inside position, just curls around very nicely. The ball's a little high, but there's no reason it shouldn't have been caught.
Zach Seiner to punt. Emmett Thomas back at his own 10 to receive. Low punt. Takes a good Oklahoma State bounce. And this will be down at the 11-yard line. A 47-yard punt. Central Michigan ball from their 11 when we come back down by 7. Game last year. Speaking to him on the phone this week, it was remarkable. On first down, Cooper Rush just throws one up incomplete to Jesse Kroll. But Petros, you and I have been on a lot of calls. We met with a lot of coaches in our time. That was one of the most impressive phone calls I've ever been on.
Yeah, the guy gets his dream job and then he's diagnosed with tonsil cancer months later, now declared cancer-free in November of 2015. Him and his wife, Paulette, have been through so much with this program, but when somebody goes through that and you're in a football team in a meeting room watching the head coach sacrifice for you in that way, it brings a team closer together, and these guys have been through a lot and they play like it. They trust each other.
It's second down and 10 here for Central Michigan. Rush has to get rid of it. He does. He finds Chapman. And Chapman able to slide through to get a couple before Ashton Lampkin brings him down.
Now remember, these backed up three and outs, that's what caused the trouble for Central Michigan defensively in the first half. And here's another big third down and long backed up. They can't afford another one, because remember, once this Central Michigan defense gets a little tired, the tempo of Oklahoma State really hurts them. And that's how these games get away from you.
Third and 7. Rush, able to complete the pass and slipping a tackle. is Jonathan Ward out of the backfield, picks up 17, a huge third down conversion. The true freshman out of Illinois.
You're going to see this Texas route come right across, and he gets it. He makes the catch and is able to run out of the arm tackle. Finds himself, I think, a little bit surprised in the open field and finds the first down. Huge for the Chippewas' field position, confidence, and the rest of their defense on the sideline.
So now first and 10 from the 31. And the handoff is to Ward. Ward, the freshman who had 9 carries for 79 yards last week, including a 45-yard touchdown run. Picks up 5 here on first down.
Yeah, he's from an exotic place for a Central Michigan guy. Illinois.
83 players from the state of Michigan who are on the Central Michigan roster.
And this guy's a very good athlete, just a freshman, but you can see a little bit electrifying when he gets the ball. Second in the state in the long jump in Illinois his senior year in high school.
Second and 5. Bocci is in. And this time, not able to turn the corner as Ward. Ramon Richards tracks him down and brings him down at the line of scrimmage. No gain at the play.
You're going to see Jonathan Ward here. He should put his foot in the ground and take that ball up. He had the blockers. He was going to get hit, but he had a 4-yard gain. But a lot of freshmen want to take it to the sideline because that's what they did in high school. There's nothing out there for you. Not against a Big 12 team with a guy like Ramon Richards ready to take you down.
Ramon Richards with 6 tackles on the day. Central Michigan 2-for-6 on third downs. Tyler Conklin in motion, a tight end. Rush finds Conklin wide open. Conklin down the sideline. He's got the first down and much more. Up to the 42, picks up 18, tripped up by Trey Flowers.
And he found himself all alone, kind of on the backside of the route. Rush finds him coming across on a drive route. I like how Conklin really made sure he secured the ball first and got the first down, and then started lumbering down the field.
Tyler Conklin is a transfer from a small division school. Was a basketball player, now playing football. And this kid, he's got good hands, good size. Already a touchdown on the day. Play action, pressure coming, and Rush is going down. DeQuinton Osborne with the sack.
Rush got a little beat up on that one. He's trying to find his composure. This is what happens when you have a freshman back in the game. You're going to see Ward get a little bit confused in the pass protection, come on the wrong side of the quarterback and try to pick up Quinton, but just no chance there. Almost a jailbreak. The Mike linebacker came as well, and the Chips didn't have a chance.
A loss of 9. And so now the true freshman Ward, he's on the sideline. Second down and 19. Back to their own 49-yard line as Devin Spaulding is back in. Rush steps into his throw, completes the pass to Zach Crouch, who got hit right away by Ramon Richards. A 5-yard completion, but Richards went low against the 6'5 Crouch, and that's just a good tackle by a corner against a tight end.
Yeah, a couple of good tackles on this drive for Ramon Richards, and these third longs are especially difficult for this Chippewa offense. They are built in a way to convert third and shorts. They have a very experienced quarterback who can make things happen, but this is not a deep threat team, essentially, against an Oklahoma State secondary.
Third and 14. Rush throws, and that one is almost picked off. Juggled. There is a flag on the field. Eric Cooper, the intended receiver, Ashton Lampkin, Ramon Richards were juggling the ball.
A lot of time for Rush there. They may get him.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, number 99. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
That's Trey Carter, a costly penalty.
You see him there, coming late free. right by Derek Edwards, the tackle, and just cleans up Rush a little late. Overall, the Chips did a great job of picking up that blitz. They came three deep on the other side. Two linebackers and a safety, and there was an open man in Cooper. The catch should have been made, but a lucky break for CMU with the roughing the passer call.
So now new life, first down to 31. Rush, he's got some room to run. Cooper Rush dives forward up to the 12-yard line, able to scramble for 19 yards. Jordan Stearns there gets credit for the tackle.
Now watch the decisiveness here by the quarterback. We saw before in the first half where he had his eyes downfield looking to throw. This time he knew there was no one to get it to. He made the decision to run. He tucked the ball, got a little bit of speed going, and then slowed down and started confusing people. It's hard for these defenders. They don't know if the quarterback's going to slide. That's a big guy. What do you do when he's coming at you?
Jare Hayes in the backfield. He had three touchdowns last week. They hand off to him. He cuts it back and takes it up to the 8, gets 4. Second down and 6 coming up.
Jare Hayes getting more experience in this program, and that was more like the type of run we should have seen from Jonathan Ward a little bit earlier in the drive. He stretched it a little bit, but when it was time to, he got both arms on the ball and got behind his feet. Transfer from the City College of San Francisco. Bonamigo, did he have to go all the way out to the West Coast to get that guy?
Second and 6. It's Hayes again. Again trying to cut it back. Second effort, pushing forward up to the 5-yard line. Able to get 3. First contact, Chad Whitener.
And these are the type of tough runs that you're going to have to see from Central Michigan against this Cowboys defense if they want to have a chance to win this game. A good job pushing the pile and making it for a pretty manageable third down situation. Remember, they can get a first down here without scoring a touchdown, so that could affect the play call.
Third and 3, they have to get to the 2 for the first down. And now a timeout is going to be used here by Central Michigan.
Central Michigan has called their first timeout.
Third and 3 from the 5 coming up when we come back for CMU.
Today, you have no idea how high this goes.
True. From the 5. 13th play of the drive coming up out of the timeout. Bocci, the fullback in. Jare Hayes, the running back. Lofting one to the end zone. Jump ball tipped. Did he catch it? Touchdown! Tyler Conklin again. 2nd touchdown of the game for the former basketball player.
Yeah, from Chesterfield, Michigan. This was a straight fade the whole way. And he's doing some hand fighting with Richards, but goes up and secures it with one hand. I love how he waited and looked at the ref the whole time waiting for the signal, because I don't know if he knew that he secured it the whole time. Tipped it to himself twice, and I think that's good. What a catch.
They could have tried for a first down. Instead, out of the timeout, no, we're going for the touchdown. And now, Brian Eby on to tie this game at 17. With 5:16 to go here in the third quarter, Central Michigan out of the MAC is all tied up with number 22 Oklahoma State out of the Big 12. Tyler Conklin from Cooper Rush. 2nd touchdown of the day.
Really reaches out there with that right hand and finds a way to secure it. This guy's a great tight end. Really good for CMU. Conklin and Kroll, both of them have been very patient, and the game has really come to them as Cooper Rush has found his rhythm throwing the ball.
17-17, 5:16 to go here in the third quarter. Brian Eby to kick off. Jeff Carr is back deep. This is in the end zone and a touchback. And time for a game break. Let's go back to L.A. and check in with Mike Hill.
All right, guys, check this one out. Ninth-ranked Georgia trailed Nichols State 14-13 midway through third, but it's come alive. Aaron Davis rocks Chase 4K. Ball's loose. Lorenzo Carter scoops and scores. 22-yard TD. Georgia with two TDs in less than a minute. They lead it 26-14 in the third. Justin Petros, back to you.
All right, so Georgia's doing okay there now, but Oklahoma State ranked number 22. They've got their hands full here. Starting at the 25, Justice Hill in the backfield to open up this drive. Rudolph hands off. And this will be a 5-yard run for Justice Hill on first down. Malik Fountain, Nathan Ricketts combined for the tackle. Well, look at these two quarterbacks. 193 yards for Cooper Rush, couple of touchdowns, both QBs with two touchdowns.
Really, the time of possession has been unbelievable. Coming into this drive, CMU with 24:55 and Oklahoma State with only 11:50 about it. And that is lopsided even for an Oklahoma State team that plays quick offense.
Second and five, again, the handoff, a big hole, Justice Hill. And that gets this crowd to its feet. A 17-yard run for a Hill. Alex Briones and Amari Coleman finally bring him down. And here, empty backfield. They go hurry up. The quick pass to McCleskey. And McCleskey gets forced out of bounds. Winslow Chapman able to push him out, picks up eight.
And that is the Cowboys' tempo there. You see the big explosive play from the back. The crowd gets excited right up to the line of scrimmage, and they get it to the slot guy out in the flat. They did that to score their first touchdown of the game to McCleskey. The tempo is really a killer in this stadium with this offense. They're good at it.
Second down and two. Play action. Rudolph with time. Wide open is McCleskey. McCleskey nearly gets stripped. Malik Fountain was coming down with that arm trying to rake it free, but it's a 28-yard pickup, and here comes Oklahoma State with tempo. First and 10 inside the 20. Rudolph to the end zone for Washington, incomplete. Amari Coleman there on the coverage.
Yeah, good job. He looked a little bit like Jordan Stearns all day. He looks like he has a little bit of hold of the back between the 2 and the 8 Washington's jersey, but not too bad, and is able to punch it away. I was really impressed with the play before. McCleskey coming across that zone right by the middle linebacker, and Rudolph having the patience to get him the ball.
Chris Carson back in at tailback now on second down and 10. Carson spinning and spins right into a bunch of players. Black jerseys, white jerseys. It's Joe Ostman. A loss of two on the play. Ostman from St. Ignace, Michigan. He's a Uper just across the Mackinac Bridge.
Mason Rudolph there checking to a run play. Thought he had something there on the weak side, and it just wasn't.
Now third and 12. Rudolph lofting one, jump ball, it's incomplete for McCleskey. Again, it's Amari Coleman there on the coverage. And so here comes the field goal unit on for Oklahoma State.
And this is good technique from that boundary corner. Look at how he tries to push McCleskey down to the sideline, but the ball was right on both of them. McCleskey wasn't quite ready for it, and Coleman was in good position. Different kicker.
Going to be a 35-yard attempt here for Ben Grogan. And Grogan able to connect from 35 yards out and give up on FS1. Your sunglasses are upside down. Maybe those are the rally sunglasses.
Well, they need it a little bit. They want to score touchdowns, not field goals. And the Chippewas did a good job of taking that punch, dealing with the tempo, especially with McCleskey getting loose on the perimeter and forcing a field goal.
Matt Amendola, who drilled that 53-yard field goal, kicks off here. Jonathan Ward will take a knee for a touchback. And Central Michigan will start at the 25. The last four possessions for Central Michigan.
Long drives.
Mm-hmm. 11 plays, 79 yards. 10 plays, 53 yards. 12 plays, 89 yards.
The longer they hold the ball,
89 yards.
Yeah, the longer they hold the ball, it's a much more difficult situation for the Cowboys. Now, again, they're used to playing a lot of downs defensively, but when you have a team with a fullback that's kind of slowly grinding you down, kind of punching you in the gut, body blows, it can really wear on you in the fourth quarter. And some of those two-yard runs become 6 or 7 yard runs. We'll see how they establish it here as the second half unfolds.
Devin Spaulding in, play clock down to two. Play action, Rush, pressured, and Rush goes down. Sacked by Jarrell Owens. Had a sack last week, now has one this week, a loss of nine.
Owens is the very experienced guy coming off the edge, played in every game in 2015, come up big in late game situations, kind of replacing Emmanuel Ogba, of course, not that he's very replaceable, but they need a guy to make big plays in those situations. And I'm not sure I really like the play call, trying for a play action situation there when you haven't really established enough of the run. I think Central Michigan's better when they're playing in front of the chains as opposed to behind them.
Rush, the quick pass to Willis, and Willis gets chased down from behind by Kirk Tucker. A 4-yard pickup. Third and long coming up. Third and 15 here for the Chippewas.
And the last third and long the Chippewas had was really elongated the drive because of a roughing the passer call. See if OSU can be disciplined here.
Setting up a little screen. It's Willis again. Edison Magruder and Trey Flowers sniffed it out. Gave up just 8 yards. Gives a little bit more room for Cooper Mojienko for him to punt. Coming up on a minute to go here in this third quarter. Jalen McCleskey is back at his own 28-yard line. McCleskey with room to return. With the speed, broke through a couple of tackles. And he is down at the 44-yard line. A 45-yard punt, 18-yard return. And a player is down now. That's Mitch Stanizek for Central Michigan. The junior out of Grand Rapids. An academic All-MAC last year.
Looks like they're checking his knee, and it was, he got whipped by his own guy. That can happen out there. Pretty good tackling by Central Michigan. Remember, Oklahoma State is known as a very good, very solid special teams touchdown scoring team and a very good defensive touchdown scoring team. And the Chips have done a good job today making sure that they've limited those big plays as Stanizek has helped off.
Stanizek got hit by his own player, number 22, Gary Jones. Not putting any pressure on that leg. Hate to see that. 35 seconds to go here in this third quarter. Rudolph His team leading by three. Rudolph stepping up, makes a move, slides forward across midfield. He's down at the 49 of Central Michigan. Gets 7 yards on first down, second and three.
I like the play by Rudolph there. He called the backs to run a route over the middle, and they kind of cleared that area out with the linebackers, and when he saw an opening, he just tucked it and went.
Does he run one more play, or is that the end of this third quarter? 7 seconds to go.
Who are we talking about? Oklahoma State, of course they're going to run a play.
Just getting it off. Little shuttle pass for McCleskey. McCleskey bounces off a defender, gets the first down, and that will end this third quarter. We've got a good one. 20-17, Oklahoma State leading Central Michigan. FS1 College Football presented by GEICO. We'll return after these messages.
College football kicks off with two intense in-state matchups. First on FS1, SMU faces Baylor. Then on Fox, BYU takes on bitter rival Utah. Don't miss all the action. Today beginning at 3.
Well, this game has been close, and the stats are close. Start of the fourth quarter. Rudolph, pump fake. And that pass is incomplete. Washington could not hold on to it. Nathan Ricketts poked it away from him. Brickwood Central Michigan has done time of possession, doubling up Oklahoma State.
Yeah, that's a big, huge deal. Even though Oklahoma State is relatively comfortable with that kind of time of possession, not with an offense like this. But they've done a good job of kind of solidifying themselves here in the second half and moving the ball more freely.
Pass, high and incomplete, looking for McCleskey. Speaking of big and huge, that circle that you drew, I mean, that was like the entire graphic.
No, it was right there over the time of possession. There's a lot of time there. You know, I had to get it all in there. I have giant fingers. Most of them are broken. That's another errant pass by Rudolph, and he had McCleskey in that little window of the zone. They've done a good job of finding some windows over the middle in that zone throughout the afternoon, but another miss by Rudolph.
Third and 10 now, 1 for 8 on third downs. Today is Oklahoma State. Rudolph has got time, dumps it off for Barry J. Sanders, and he gets bottled up just 1 yard. And I tell you what, it was a late arriving crowd here at Boone Pickens Stadium after the half. A lot of fans left, and the fans that have stayed, they're not happy with what they're seeing. They're in a ball game against the Chippewas of Central Michigan. Zach Siner is on to punt. Emmett Thomas is back inside his own 10. Trying to down it, and they will. They will down it at the 5. A 37-yard punt. Siner is doing his job.
Timeout on the field for media.
Just underway here in the fourth quarter. 14 minutes to go. A 3-point game. Oklahoma State in a fight with Central Michigan. Mike Gundy's team. And they'll have to go a long way right now, starting at their own 5.
Let's see if they can grind it out or if the athleticism of the Cowboys is going to take over here in the fourth quarter.
Jare Hayes in the backfield to open up this drive, and he gets stopped at the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Okay. last year's game, 24-13, Oklahoma State won. Central Michigan led 13-10 in the third quarter.
This one doesn't feel too much different, does it?
No. Another handoff up the middle. Hayes able to get some breathing room. Up to the 12, gets 7. Jordan Stearns trips him up.
Just like you said, that breathing room was great, and Hayes did a good job getting underneath the guard who was pulling around. Watch number 70 pull around here, and then Hayes will get right underneath him, and that's a great job. That's how you run power. You got to get right off that guard's behind and find a hole. He could even got closer to that guard and had a better chance of breaking that tackle.
Now a third and 3. And 4 for 10 on third downs. Rush to throw, and he completes the pass to Conklin, and Conklin has the first down. So Tyler Conklin is having himself a day.
Conklin there in the slot. You see him number 83. He runs what they call an out route. Didn't really sell the inside much at all because he had to get out and show his numbers to the quarterback. And that's what I would call a possession type of catch. He really made sure he had it, and he was right at the sticks. Well done.
Gets the first down. Play clock down to 3. Down to 1. Rush just gets it off. Over the middle. Flags are thrown. Conklin comes down with it for 15 yards. Josiah Kim there on the tackle.
Conklin and Rush are putting on a bit of a show against a Big 12 defense here. Let's see what the call is. It came from the secondary.
Holding defense number 9. The penalties declined. The play results in a first down.
The hold is there, and you can see it, but no matter to Conklin, he's strong, and he's able to go up and make that catch. Cooper Rush takes another pretty good shot from 2 D linemen from the Cowboys. But he stands in now.
Jonathan Ward, the true freshman, now in at tailback. The handoff to him. And Ward got hit right away by Vincent Taylor, the big junior out of San Antonio. No gain, 2nd and 10.
It's been very difficult for the Chippewas to get any kind of push in this front 7 of Oklahoma State simply because of their size.
Handoff. Spaulding. And he's going to lose some. Mote Maile. Third and 13 coming up here for Central Michigan.
Another big third down. Just having such a hard time establishing their run. They've had a great time of possession number throughout the game. They've done what they wanted to do, I think, offensively. And you see those third down conversions. Oklahoma State 1 out of 9. Central Michigan's had more success.
Central Michigan has called their
with the play clock winding down. CMU forced to call a timeout. Third and long coming up.
Okay. I know Greg Ward's shoulders hurt today. He's not going to play against Lamar. But after watching him against Oklahoma, my goodness, Nick Chubb is still great. And what can you say about JT Barrett? He leads a great team.
On 3rd and 13, going deep over the middle, complete. Mark Chapman has it all the way down to the 31 of Oklahoma State. On 3rd and 13, they get 41.
Chapman loops with the outside receiver and ends up on the inside and makes a great play. He appeared in all 13 games last year. He's got great chemistry with Cooper Rush. And pardon me for saying they weren't really a downfield threat against Oklahoma State. That's about as downfield as you can get in a huge conversion.
All of a sudden, Central Michigan in great shape. Out of the timeout, Cooper Rush lofting one to his running back Spalding for the touchdown. 31 yards. And Central Michigan has taken its first lead of the game.
Now it is hard for a tailback to adjust to a deep ball and find it out of the sky like that. What a job by Devin Spalding. You're going to see him take an outside route. Nobody really gets any kind of piece of him. He goes right by the Mike linebacker, Chad Whitener, for the play, and a perfect throw by Cooper Rush. And how about that? Boone Pickens Stadium shocked. Two deep balls in a row from Cooper Rush, and the Chips have the lead.
Brian Evie's extra point is good. 72 yards on the last two passes. Cooper Rush, first to Mark Chapman, then to Devin Spalding, his running back. Oh, wow. 9.40 to go. Central Michigan up by four. How about Cooper Rush? 4 for 4 in that drive, 91 yards. They went 95 yards. Every drive seems to be long. Evie to kick off. And I think this one may have been blown off the tee as he was coming to kick.
The ball fell off the tee just prior to it being kicked.
You're right.
The play will be replayed.
Imagine that moment of panic. Right there, when you're the kicker and you realize you're going to have to kick the ball the wrong way. You're praying that that official blows the whistle, and he did, luckily for Evie.
Chris Lacy and Jeff Carr back deep for Oklahoma State.
Well, you know what Boone Pickens says, this is the Saudi Arabia of wind. You know, there's a lot of wind here in Oklahoma. You can take advantage of that.
Carr will take a knee in the end zone. A couple of big throws by Cooper Rush on that last drive.
First, the beautiful one and the holding call to Conklin. They didn't need the call. There's Chapman way down the field on the third and long. And then the very next play, beautiful throw on the wheel route by Devin Spalding, who hauled it in like a wide receiver, just like his offensive coordinator Morris Watts told us. Devin Spalding, I've been pretty impressed with. He's standing there with Cooper Rush, and you see his numbers. Cooper Rush, so poised, came out in this game not looking himself, took a couple hits, a couple of errant passes, but things have changed dramatically for him, and let's see what Mason Rudolph can muster up with this team at home in trouble in the fourth quarter.
In trouble indeed, down by four on first down. Rudolph throwing, and he completes the pass to Jawan Seals for 17 yards. That's a good start to the drive here for the Cowboys. They go back to Seals. And Seals gets wrapped up by Josh Cox. The Cowboys sideline is looking for a flag. They don't get it. An 11-yard completion. So back-to-back first downs to Jawan Seals, who has been quiet in this game.
On the field for a Central Michigan injury.
Injured player.
That's Tony Anise, the best safety, really the defensive leader for the Chippewas. And he started limping around after the original throw to Seals. And they got the playoff before he could get down or get off the field. You see, when they're stretching him out, it usually is a cramp, and you hope for that.
It's a guy on the Jim Thorpe Award watch list.
Well, he's a stud, a high school quarterback, and there's a lot of those guys out here for this Central Michigan team, a lot of guys that played high school quarterback, which means they have a great understanding of the game, but they're also tough.
T Two passes on the drive for Mason Rudolph, both to Juwan Seals. They've gone for 28 yards. Rudolph gets rid of it to Carson. And Carson able to dive forward up to the 35. A 12-yard completion. And Rudolph barking out instructions. Oklahoma State going quickly again. Quick pass. McCleskey. And this is Oklahoma State football right now. Briones and Cox combined for the tackle. A 9-yard completion to McCleskey. That's the 10th catch. That's the 11th catch of the day for McCleskey.
Oh, he's had a good day.
A career day.
They like to throw it to him immediately after they get a first down out there in the flat. You can see the Pokes can take momentum back in a hurry.
Justice Hill on the carry. And that's a good open field tackle by Sean Bunting.
Just a freshman. Bunting doing a good job of breaking down and making the tackle. Getting right to the knees of Hill before he could make another move and get upfield.
Second and 9 from the 24. Rudolph, 4 for 4 on the drive. Pressure, and Rudolph goes down. Sacked. Nate Brisson Fast, a loss of 6.
Brisson Fast is only 260 pounds, but he's rangy. There he makes an inside move and just kind of muscles by the guard and gets his arms on Mason Rudolph. Marcus Keys, the left guard, beat on that play. He's the only, one of the only new starters on this Oklahoma State front.
Now a 3rd and 15. Oklahoma State 1 for 9 on third downs today. Rudolph, pressure coming. Lost one to the sideline, and it's incomplete. The flag is thrown. Another flag is thrown. Chris Lacy, the intended receiver, bunting on the coverage. I'd love to see a replay of this.
I think we can accommodate you.
Pass interference, defense, number 27. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
This is the freshman out there, Justin, and it looked like he was being grabbed.
Right.
Kind of double grabbing. To me, that would be a no call. Lacy with his arms all over him. You saw one flag come and then the other one, and they both decided it would be on the freshman, Bunting. I don't know if I like that call. I thought that was pretty good coverage. He got grabbed first.
That's why I wanted to see it.
Exactly right.
That's the second pass interference on a 3rd and long against Central Michigan. Happened on the opening drive with James Washington. That's 5 penalties for 60 yards against CMU. Now Jeff Carr in the backfield. On first down, the whistle is blown before the snap.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, number 28, 5-yard penalty, first down.
They got James Washington, and that's who they were trying to get the ball to. So James Washington just a little antsy there,
game
knowing they were trying to get him the ball.
Please reset the game clock to 7 minutes, 22 seconds.
Here he is.
7:22.
Just a second early with that stutter step, and that's what drew the flag.
Pass to Lacy. Otis Kearney on the tackle, a pickup of 7. So it should be 2nd down and 8. And the way that Central Michigan moves the ball, you wonder, you may have to score a touchdown if you're Oklahoma State.
The
field goal may not be good enough.
They definitely go a lot slower. I mean, these two teams could not be more different. And it's very interesting seeing them come up against each other here in the fourth quarter in a tight game.
Rudolph swings it out for Carson. Where do they mark him? It looks like he has the first down. A 9-yard completion. Joe Ostman able to finally get him out.
And that is a harder throw than it looks. 1 foot in front of the numbers for Carson. A very nice delivery for Rudolph, and a good job by Carson staying in bounds and getting the first down.
The ruling on the field on the previous play was complete pass out of bounds. That ruling is under further review.
Well, let's see if he stepped out of bounds before the first down marker.
This will be a spot issue because I think the completion was made.
Right.
We'll see if he gets out of bounds before the marker. There you see, obviously a completion. I think he towed it. I think he did a pretty good job of towing it, unless one of those early feet that came down was out. I think that's a pretty good call.
It would be the right foot.
Yeah, where was the ball?
Let's bring in Mike Pereira.
Five.
Mike, you're looking at this as we're looking at this. And
yeah, I mean, we're looking down the sidelines, and he really doesn't step out of bounds until he gets to the 5-yard line. His left foot is the one that comes closest, about a 7, but the shot that we showed shows that there is a little bit of green between that white and the field. So I think until that right foot steps out of bounds, he's good. He's okay there with that foot, and I think really you're looking at him being out of bounds right there at the 5. I think it has to stay as a first down.
The replay official is Richard Jordan. If it stands, it will be a first down. It'll be first and goal from the 5 for Oklahoma State. Now, we did speak with Richard Jordan during halftime to ask about the first touchdown of the game scored by Jalen McCleskey, which ironically enough was also on this same sideline. And we thought maybe he had stepped out of bounds. It was close. Why didn't it go to review? And we spoke to Richard Jordan. He said, I looked at it up here, and based on all the camera angles, I looked at it. I didn't stop the game because no matter how I looked at it, I didn't have enough evidence to overturn it. So I could have stopped the game and looked and looked and looked, and it would have stood.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. The pass was complete, and the runner was out of bounds at the 5-yard line. First down.
And by the way, once again, Mike Pereira is correct.
100%. I wonder if he'll be 100% all day. I would bet on it.
It's a pretty good bet.
And he's going to look good on camera, too.
10th play of the drive is coming up. Mason Rudolph is perfect on this drive, although I don't know if you like all those sixes. Carson in the backfield. First and goal from the 5. Down by 4 are the Cowboys. That one is picked off in the end zone. Josh Cox, the first turnover of the game.
What a read by Josh Cox. And his defensive coordinator, Greg Colby, told us he's very smart. He's a very heady player out of Warren, Michigan. Watch him recognize this and get under the ball where Washington has no chance at it. The throw was errant. There's no doubt about it. And we've seen a lot of those from Mason Rudolph today. But a great job by Cox seeing it and getting under it. And Rudolph's reaction, man, would he love to have that back.
He was a perfect 6 for 6 on the drive prior to that. What a turn of events here. Now 6:33 to go. Central Michigan has one timeout remaining. Look at this. Now the defense has to step up for Oklahoma State. On first down, the handoff to Spalding. It's Spalding. Has it taken away? There's the defense stepping up for Oklahoma State.
And that was him, Devontae Avery. receiver it, the guy that stripped the ball last week and flipped it over to Ramon Richards for that great touchdown. He does it again and rips that ball away from
really
Kevin Spaulding.
Fumble recovered by the defense.
There's Spaulding, and look at number 40 get in there and rip. You see him, he did it again. He did it last week. Dislodges that ball, and what a great play. And that's part of the opportunistic nature of this Cowboys defense. They teach that stuff and try to get as many turnovers as you can. And man, did they need that. Glenn Spencer's got to be happy.
The fumble recovery in return of 10 yards. It is Devontae Averett out of Detroit, Michigan, playing against Central Michigan.
Now he's up. That's
the
guy.
He's up, and he gets the ovation.
He was a boxer in high school, Justin, and I think that helps with his hands.
I agree.
You get those quick hands to get in and dislodge the ball, and it's not easy to get the ball away from Spaulding. He is an experienced back. Great play.
Wow. The answer by Glenn Spencer's defense. Giving the ball back to the offense. Now, can Central Michigan's defense answer and just hold Oklahoma State to 3? Mason Rudolph with second life. Carson in the backfield. It's Carson on the handoff. Up the middle. And he gets the 7. Malik Fountain, Nathan Ricketts combined for the stop, a 5-yard pickup.
Rudolph's got a lot of poise, but he really has missed some throws this afternoon. And I think it's smart to get Carson the ball there and just try to get a little closer, get a little more comfortable.
Rudolph looks to the sidelines. Changes the play. Play clock winding down. Rudolph locked in one in the corner of the end zone again. Incomplete, looking for James Washington. Amari Coleman there on the coverage. 3rd and 5 coming up.
Well, they're trying to get the ball to Washington every way they can. Trying to get into the hands of their playmakers and just another fade. Good job by Coleman, and ball's just a little far for Washington to get to. They don't seem to be on the same page as far as where they want to place those fades.
1 for 9 on third downs today. Rudolph, design run, Rudolph! He's got himself the first down. He's down shy of the end zone.
And I like that he went and got it himself. He's been struggling a little bit. Now they're going to go fast.
Wait a minute. Timeout on the field for measurement.
Or maybe it's real close to that first down marker.
Here's the play. It was a call draw. You see it because Carson went to lead block on the backside. Rudolph is a big guy. 6'5", 235, can lean that big body down.
Tell you, from the initial run, it looked like he had it. From this, the spot, wow.
Well, the fans don't like it here in Stillwater. Now this is a situation on a 4th and really short that you would usually wonder if the quarterback could get under center and run a quarterback sneak, but they don't do a lot of that. Here's the spot again. Where was the knee down? It's hard to tell in that cluster of tacklers.
Look at that initial spot where the... Well, it's 4th and 1. Carson's in. Whistle before the snap. Timeout taken by Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State has taken their first timeout of the half. This will be a 30-second team timeout. Timeout on the field for media.
Fourth and one coming up. Formation and the direct toss. Touchdown. James Washington. Flag on the play. Dylan Stoner is lined up at quarterback. Direct snap to James Washington.
There's no foul on the play for holding. The resulting play is a touchdown.
Well, there you go. We told you that Mason Rudolph didn't have to come off the field anymore from the quarterback position in the red zone. But he did. They replaced him with a true freshman, Dylan Stoner, who didn't even take the snap and went straight to Washington coming across.
Oh, it was
a pass. He got it and pushed it forward. Yeah, that happened quickly. So touchdown pass for Dylan Stoner. Congratulations, young man. True freshman. Slot receiver with the touchdown pass.
Now Grogan on for the extra point. Oklahoma State is back on top by three with 5:12 to go. Points off turnovers.
Now that was a very timed up play. A great job by Brad Lundblade, the center, to really time up the snap and look at Washington. He's really got to throttle down and really keep an eye on Stoner until he's able to secure the ball. Montemago not happy. And that's how he felt when the flag was picked up. He saw a hold. And if there was a flag, you'd have to assume somebody else saw a hold too. They picked it up.
So all of a sudden, Mason Rudolph, who thought he may have cost his team the game by throwing that interception in the end zone, his defense gotten the ball back thanks to that strip fumble by Devontae Averett. And now, after the timeout, and a great call by Mike Gundy and the offensive coordinator Mike Yurcich. They put in the freshman Dylan Stoner. A little shovel pass to James Washington. And now it's a 3-point lead for Oklahoma State.
And a great resiliency by Oklahoma State. After the interception, you're down. The crowd is out of it, not to get dejected and to force that turnover.
Mark Chapman's going to return it from a couple yards deep in his own end zone. Chapman trying to cut it back. And he'll get out to the 26. So the last couple of minutes has been kind of crazy.
First you have the pick. Rudolph throwing it right to Josh Cox, really. Then Spalding gets stripped beautifully by Averett. And the Cowboys ground it out a little bit. Finally, the Wildcat forward pass touchdown to Washington. And Bonamigo doesn't like it. I don't blame him.
Devin Spalding is back in at tailback. About 5 minutes to go. One timeout remaining for Central Michigan. Cooper Rush. He'll pass to his fullback, Joe Bocci. And Bocci makes the catch for 7 yards. Tackled by Averett. Second and three coming up.
Now can the Oklahoma State defense kind of bow up and force the Chips into something desperate here? We'll see. They've had a hard time getting off the field on third downs and stopping Cooper Rush from completing passes.
Hand off to Spalding. He gets hit right away. Cole Waltershine, a loss of two. Third and five coming up. Six for 13 on third downs is Central Michigan. Rush swings it out, completes the pass to Spaulding. Another third down conversion for the Chippewas.
Spaulding doing a good job of kind of getting down and bending his knees and getting that ball. He just runs a swing route and then to the flat and has to kind of dig down to get that. Finds the first down and the Chips stay alive.
Spaulding picks up the pressure. The pass is picked off. Ramon Richards steps in front of Jesse Krull. Look at Glenn Spencer.
They needed their defense to force turnovers here in the fourth quarter. Coach Bonamigo can't believe it. It looked a little bit like Rush tried to force it in there, and he did. And Ramon Richards just strong on the coverage right there. Seemed like the ball just kind of dropped into his midsection. Richards just turns and finds it. Ill-advised throw by Rush. And here's Coach. Loves it. Glenn Spencer giving Averett the chest.
Sideline warning, Oklahoma State during the play. That's the first sideline warning of the game, and there will be no yardage markup for the warning.
I guess they'll take it.
Yeah. That's the first real mistake of the game by Cooper Rush. And the last two possessions have resulted in turnovers for Central Michigan. And a key for this game, a key for every game for Oklahoma State, is creating turnovers and winning that turnover battle. And it looked like before, when the interception in the end zone, all of a sudden Central Michigan might win that turnover. Back-to-back possession, Glenn Spencer's defense have forced turnovers. And now Central Michigan needs its defense to do something special. Hand off to Carson. And Carson needs to get down to stay in. He does.
Took a hit.
He did.
Yeah, this is a tough thing because this is not natural for the Cowboys. They are not a natural, what we call in football, four-minute drill team, which is run the ball, wait for the rep to ask for the ball, you know, all those things, and go slow.
Taking the final timeout of the game. This will be a 30-second team timeout. Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 2 minutes 56 seconds. 2:56.
Well, this game,
this will be a full time.
I like it, fine. I'm growing it out.
Sounds like my family. I think he looks good. And they love him here in Oklahoma State. He is, yeah, fear the mullet. They love him. They've been very, very blessed with him as the head coach, a guy who played here, who's fostered in, like you said, the golden era of Cowboys football with that football giant right down the road in Norman. The Cowboys are doing great things here in Stillwater.
Rennie Childs now in after Carson went down. Rudolph to throw. Completes the pass to Carson. Carson breaks a couple of tackles down the sideline and gets forced out by Amari Coleman.
And that's really what was kind of missing, wasn't it, earlier in the game for this Oklahoma State team as a whole. They weren't forcing turnovers and they weren't really breaking tackles with their backs. Well, they forced two turnovers now down the stretch, and he breaks a tackle from Briones and again on Josh Cox, two very good defenders for the Chippewas, and gets it for the first down after taking that big shot on first down. Nice play by Carson.
Carson, 80 total yards on the day. Hand off to Childs. gets a yard. Chapman, Briones combined for the tackle.
And no more timeouts for the Chips. If Oklahoma State can run the ball and be sound, they should be able to finish this, but they are not really comfortable running the ball.
You see number 21 right there, Nathan Ricketts. He's wearing number 21, and we talked about the head coach for Central Michigan before, John Bonamigo, how he overcame cancer. Well, number 21 has a very special meaning for Central Michigan. Derek Nash was a player who never got to suit up for Central Michigan. He passed away on June 22nd of 2015 from leukemia, from Saginaw, Michigan.
Oklahoma State has taken their second time out of the half. This will be a 30-second
He went to Carleton High School in Saginaw. And when he passed away, Coach Bonamigo said that no single player will ever wear number 21 again. And he said, I promise you that you will never be forgotten. And so now, for every game, it is an incredible honor for a player to wear number 21. And last week, it was Winslow Chapman who wore number 21, got his first career interception. This week, it's Nathan Ricketts wearing number 21. And each week, a different player wears it. And that means that no matter what, while Derek Nash is not on the field, he is with them.
And it's wonderful symbolism for a football team. There's no doubt about it. And young men like this dealing with mortality and seeing what their coach went through last year has really brought this team closer together. And it shouldn't be a surprise that they found themselves in a hostile environment up against a ranked team. And even though they got down early, they were able to lock arms together and make a real game of this. And they're still in it. And I think it's a real testament to the program. A special thing's going on in Mount Pleasant.
Now Rudolph trying to take more time off the clock. Loses a couple yards.
And they're just going to try to milk this to death. Two more downs. Got to be frustrating for the Chippewas, which is hard as they fought in this game. Two fourth quarter turnovers really changed the fate.
Again, just trying to take as much time off the clock as Mason Rudolph can. About a 5 second differential. Tell you what, Oklahoma State got all they wanted in this game from Central Michigan.
And they saw it coming.
Yeah.
You know, it was a tight game last year on the road. I think they felt like they were going to play a lot better here at Boone Pickens Stadium. And maybe they did play a little better than they did last year. But at the same time, Central Michigan took a lead in the second half. They fought them hard. They played the game they wanted. The inability to get a run game going.
Oklahoma State has taken their final timeout of the game. This will be a 30-second team timeout.
4 seconds left.
They couldn't really get Spalding going in any kind of consistent way. And that really hurt their ability to move the ball. The heck of a fourth quarter, though, Justin.
Oh, remarkable. The interception by Josh Cox. You're thinking, what do we have here? And then the strip fumble. The Wildcat, James Washington, running it in to take the lead back. There was a flag. It was picked up. And then the interception. And defensive coordinator Glenn Spencer fired up as his defense got its second turnover in as many possessions.
Devin Spalding thinking hard about that fumble. Young man out of Westland, Michigan, junior. Played a lot of football for the Chips, and they're going to need him this year.
On fourth and 13, just throwing it up.
What's that?
That'll do it. It wasn't easy, but it's a win. And Oklahoma State will move to 2-0 on the season. You know that there is respect from Mike Gundy for John Bonamigo. The officials getting together right now.
And
the flag is thrown.
John Bonamigo's kept clapping. The chips are still in it.
Intentional grounding. Number two was still in the pocket, and there was no receiver in the area. That's a loss of down foul at the spot of the foul, and there will be one untimed down.
Wow.
First down, Central Michigan.
You can't just throw it up, I guess. There wasn't anybody in the area. They didn't run anybody down the field, and I guess the officials knew exactly what the Cowboys were trying to do in this situation. And there was nobody down the field. Yeah, nobody's down the field. Nobody ran out on a route. They were all in a protection. They were all in that pocket cup. And there's nobody there. Great call by the officials and a good catch.
It wasn't a man.
Well, this now is even more interesting.
The chips are still alive.
Let's see where they're going to spot it.
They're going to walk off the penalty. We're going to have an untimed down. You know, they say a game can't end on a defensive penalty. In this case, a game can't end on an offensive penalty either.
So it's spotted at the 49 of Central Michigan. Cooper Rush is in a shotgun. Three players lined up essentially by the goal line. Rush stepping up, throwing to Kroll, catches the lateral. Here comes Willis. Willis racing to the end zone. Touchdown! Unbelievable! Central Michigan does it!
The ruling on the field is touchdown. The previous play is under further review.
I've never seen anything like that. Cooper Rush did not have the arm strength to get the ball all the way down into the end zone for a conventional Hail Mary. So they get it to Kroll, who's able, while he's going down, to flip it to the former high school quarterback, Corey Willis, who ran about 50 yards across the field to take it to the house.
51 yards.
Here's Kroll right here. You're going to see Rush put everything he can into it, and it's not going to get to the end zone. Kroll does a great job of getting and letting it go immediately. What a play, and it had to be called that way. They came out of the huddle expecting to do that and pulled it off. People here are blown away. Now, was he in the end zone clean? He's got the lean. He's got the stretch. It looked like that left knee was down, but I think the ball was over in time. Ashton Lampkin was trying to wrestle him down.
Let's bring in Mike Pereira right now, who's been watching. Mike, the officials are looking it over. What do you see?
Yeah, I'll tell you, we've been having a real discussion here as to whether or not they should have extended this game for the one play period, because the rule book does state that you don't extend for an offensive penalty if the offensive penalty includes loss of down, which the intentional grounding did. So
wow.
As we look at it here, yeah, we think this is a touchdown, but we really think we're looking at a misenforced penalty here and not and extending the game when it shouldn't have been extended period.
Because they extended it, Mike, an extra
and I'll
play.
Read you, I'll read you the actual rule about the extension of periods. It says a penalty is accepted for live ball fouls. You will replay it. Exception, the period is not extended if the foul is by the team in possession and the statement of the penalty includes loss of down. So it really indicates that really they were in error of extending the period as it was.
Do you think they will somehow excise that last play from the record because the game perhaps should have been over based on the rule you just read us?
I don't think you can do that, Petros, when you've already run a play. But, you know, they did discuss it. You saw them have a discussion about it. They all got together before the
Here comes the ruling.
The play did get extended, but I don't think
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. Central Michigan touchdown. That's the end of the ball game.
Unreal. Unreal.
They were still in it the whole way. They never didn't believe. The beating heart of the Chips was unflappable. In Stillwater today, I can't believe what we saw. That was pretty special.
On a play that Mike Pereira just told us should never have probably happened, we just saw the improbable happen. And look at this.
Great play by Kroll, getting the ball, securing it, finding the man he was supposed to pitch it to, Corey Willis, immediately almost, and getting it to him, and Willis knew where to go. The celebration was wild. These guys weren't worried about what Pereira was talking about. And here's when the ref makes the call, Coach Bonamigo. Briones with the finger to the lips, and that's that.
To 27, Central Michigan with the upset over Oklahoma State here in Stillwater. Still in shock. Right now, let's get you to wait.